Alright, we're back for more. Plaza of Bollocks. The Plaza of Mild Love. Moving on. Wow, they're still praying! Come on, man. It's gotta be one of them, for fuck's sake. Like, you're in a place where you've gotta fucking put your head on the ground for 2 days. I'm fairly certain probably most of them are bloody well asleep. Can't be that fucking hard for one of them to think, boop, 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 just gonna get up, walk up these steps, stab a bloke and walk back down. The religious devotion of our people is the pride of our kingdom. Come what may, they will continue to pray until tomorrow afternoon. Well, I will say this, this level of devotion is certainly to be respected. Shame it's in a plaza. Now, to find Emma. Who the fuck are you? You there! Wait. I want to ask you something. Okay. Do you know me? And do I know you? Well, I'm Phoenix. Phoenix Wright. I'm a lawyer. No, no! I want to know if you know who I am. Uh-huh? How should I know? I've never ever seen you before. This guy's acting really strange. I wonder if he has amnesia or something. I should talk to him a little more, just in case he's connected to this case somehow. Oh, it can't be him, look at him. Are you having trouble remembering who you are? Ah! I'm sorry if I offended you! Whew, I thought he was gonna pull a weapon on me. But he's just pulling some snack out one after another. I'm trying to remember what I'm supposed to do. I know it's something important. Do you know this man or something, Barbed Head? No, I've just said I've never seen him before, didn't I? Are you Lady Kira? You know of Lady Kira? Then you are Kira-Aze, I take it. Nom 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 nom. Maybe? Wait. Are those lizards he's eating? Yes. Many, many lizards. What? You want one? No thanks! I just ate! Ah, now I remember. Get a load of this. Well? Well what? I believe he suffers from a far more serious malady than mere memory loss. Ah, Rafer, you're cool. No good, huh? Guess I'll try somebody else. Okay. So, who was that man? And what did he want, Barbed Head? I wish I knew. Hey, Mr. Wright! Ah, what now? What's wrong? I didn't surprise you that badly, did I? Oh no, it's nothing. Actually, I've been looking for you. I wanted to tell you I investigated the crime scene. I hope it wasn't too much trouble getting my investigation of the Inner Sanctum approved. Oh, it was fine. Prosecutor Sarmadi gave his okay straight away. He seems like a rather fair-minded prosecutor. He said that you would probably give up once you saw the crime scene for yourself. And that moving on before the trial began would be the smart thing to do. He must be feeling really confident about his case. Well, just so you know, I've no intention of giving up. I figured! That's why I prepared a little gift for you. I thought it might help your investigation. Here, it's all yours. I wanted to bring you a bunch of other forensic tools, but they were confiscated at the airport. Luminol testing fluid. This actually might come in handy. Also, I made a copy of the crime scene photo for you. Thanks! All of this will definitely come in handy. Oh wow, you got fucked. So this is what the High Priest's body looked like after the murder. Well, why is he partly sub... Oh no, no, I can see it. No, he's pretty submerged. Okay. I'll keep this along with the picture I took at the crime scene. Sorry, it just didn't look like some of it. Like, some of him was submerged and some of him wasn't. Oh yeah! They're done questioning Maya. Really? I should go pay her a visit then. Poor Maya, she must be feeling pretty lonely. I should let her know that I'll be defending her too. Oh shoot, look at the time! I have to get going. You sure seem busy. That's because his what the fuck is that? Ephemeral holiness is a real slave driver. His ephemeral holiness? Prosecutor Sarmadi, he's like the world's hardest riddle, wrapped in a flowy sash. I keep wondering if it's just a clash of cultures type of thing, you know? Like, he'll ask the most insane things of me without batting a single long eyelash of his. This prosecutor Sarmadi sounds like he's used to holding some serious clout. Ah, why do I have such bad luck with prosecutors? First it was the glimmerous fop. And now that I'm finally rid of that grating, bling-loving Europhile, I get this guy. Oh no! Now I'm really gonna be late! It'll probably make me listen to one of those really long sutras again! I'll see you later! He makes her listen to sutras? Sounds like Emma's got it pretty rough too.
Hang on.
She does not appreciate Prosecutor Sarmadi's sutras? What ingratitude! It appears that she, too, is lacking in religious devotion. I don't think that's what the problem is here. Besides, Emma's not even a karateist.
We got anything? No, she is actually going to help us out. Interesting. She's actually quite a cool character, though. I kind of like that. It's sort of like, she's very, sort of forward and, confident, but then it's also like she's not massively smart. Yeah, fair enough. I think she's cool. Oh no! Don't be sad! Come on, Phoenix has got any out of dumber shit than this. Twice, I think. Nick! I knew you'd come! Maya, she sure looks tired. How are you holding up?
It wasn't me, but no one will believe me. I have to admit, I'm still a bit in shock. Who'd have thought you'd get caught up in something like this, and so far from home? But I'm going to defend you, so hang in there. We can do this if we work together.
Eh, this is all my fault. I mean, you came to Karain just to visit me. We hadn't seen each other in ages, and then this happened.
I haven't seen her this down in ages either. Come on, remember who you're talking to! Besides, I'd thought you'd be used to being the usual suspect by now.
Yeah.
I guess you're right. And you've saved me each and every time. Yep, so just tell me everything you can and let's go from there. Barbed Head, stop stalling and go straight to the matter of true import. We know she is the murderer, therefore it is time for a confession. Your benevolence! What brings the royal priestess to a place like this? I am watching over this lawyer to keep him from tampering with anything in this case. Now, out with it! Confess to your crime! But please, your benevolence, could you please take it down a notch or three? Maya, please tell me what you can. I know this must be difficult, but anything you can remember might help.
Sure, okay.
The incident.
I didn't kill the High Priest. I wouldn't even dream of it. I mean, he always treated me so well. Abbot in me was an important figure with a ton of duties, including training acolytes. He was really kind, even to a foreigner like me. Wow, even she appreciates the racism. Jesus. Oh, man. Oh, it's starting to die now. There we go. Oh, I could not do an audiobook. Although that would be a very interesting venture, I have to say. He even invited me over to his house whenever I was between training sessions. How could I ever kill someone like that? He sounds like a really good person. I think I would have liked him. Yeah, every single time that happens, they tend to die. It was so much fun. I got to enjoy meals with his family and everything. And his wife was a master of Karanese cuisine. I've never eaten better in my life. It's like they were a family, a home away from home in this foreign land. There must have been a source of comfort, what with being here for training all alone. But what? I can't completely deny the charge either. Huh? As I suspected, the snake has shown her true colors at last! Your benevolence, please! I'm trying to figure out what really happened here. So what do you mean you can't completely deny the charge? Well, during the purification, right, I suddenly got really, really sleepy. The next thing I knew, Abbott in me was, you know... You suddenly got sleepy? So then you didn't actually see the High Priest get murdered? No, I didn't, but... If I was possessed by some crazed spirit while I was asleep, then... Oh yeah, they have done that, whatever they... That was weird. What an excuse! How dare you pin your crime on another person's soul! Eh. Be honest, what you call training is but an extended vacation in reality. And that training here is simply for prestige. No, it's not like that at all! I'm training to become the master of the Karai channeling technique. A neophyte practitioner such as you become a channeling master? I think not. The spiritual power acquired is beyond the means of an outsider like you. Rafer seems to really hate fakers. But Maya does actually have the power to channel spirits. I should let Rafer know. Your benevolence, I wouldn't call Maya a neophyte because she can already wait, Nick! What? Can I talk to you for a second? Why is she whispering all of a sudden? I want to keep my spirit channeling ability a secret while I'm here, Nick. What? Why? I'll, explain later. Just keep it a secret for now, okay? If you say so. What's that all about? What is all that whispering about over there? Oh, it's nothing really. I'll have to ask about this later when Princess Rafe is not around. Oh, I almost forgot. Nick. Yes? About Abba Inmi's murder. There was something I noticed that I thought strange. Oh? So, what was it that you noticed? Well, you probably won't believe me, but why don't you let me be the judge of that? Okay, so, you know that spring? The spring? You mean the pool in front of the Warbard statue? Yes, that. The water in there was dark red. And when I say dark red, I mean blood red. Oh, that? Yeah, I saw it too. You did? Yeah, the High Priest's blood turned it red. What? No, that's not what I meant. The spring was red before he was killed. What? Wait, so it was already red, even before the High Priest was killed? Yeah, I noticed it during the purification rite, just before I passed out. It's just like the ancient legend says. What ancient legend? The spring shall run red upon Lady Kira's return. That's how it goes, anyway. Hold on! Yes, there is a legend about the Inner Sanctum that says just that. But the water runs red this time thanks to the murder. The police investigation confirmed it. Perhaps your eyes were deceived by the lantern light reflecting off of the water. I don't think that was it, though. An ancient legend, huh? I wonder if it's connected to this murder somehow. Oh... Clues! Nick? Yes? So, actually, there's one more thing. What's up with Maya? She keeps looking over at her benevolence, like she's worried what Rafer will think. There's something I want to show you. There is? I found this at the Inner Sanctum after I came to. Is this a letter? It's in Karadaese. See that stamp on the far left at the end of the letter? Does it look familiar? This red stamp here? That's the mark of Lady Kira. Oh, right. It looks just like the mark on her forehead. Lady Kira, you say? Let me see that! Why, this is... What? What does it say? Do not perform the rite. I know what you are planning, Lady Kira. That sounds like a threat. Or a warning. Whoever's pretending to be Lady Kira was pressuring the High Priest to stop the rite. Yeah, that's what it looks like to me, too. Nick, do you think? Wait. First, there's that ancient legend.
Don't.
The spring shall run red upon Lady Kira's return. Now, there's also Lady Kira's warning. Plus, with the Warbard dagger being eyed as a murder weapon. Don't tell me! That's why she has to be the real deal. I get the chills just thinking about it. Fucking flashback! Stop it! That lady here is here to possess the sacred herb or something. Don't tell me. You actually believe that the real Lady Kira returned to kill the High Priest? Don't be silly, Nick. Huh? Historical figures don't come back to life. I mean, give me a break. But you were saying only yesterday how it was more fun to believe that she's the real deal. Yeah, yesterday! I wish I could keep on entertaining that fantasy too. But the fact is, we're dealing with a murder here. Thus, my days of dreaming have come to an end. I'm going to keep it real from now on, and you should too, Nick. I thought you said I was the boring one because I was keeping it real. Sorry, I guess I've outgrown that stepladder argument we always have. I think you mean ladder, Maya. So, what do you mean by keeping it real? Oh, so you know how someone is dressing up like Lady Kira and capturing rebels, right? Oh, you mean the rebel hunter Lady Kira in the papers? Yeah, that one. I think that's who probably sent this warning. What nonsense is this? You dare to suggest that Abbot Inmay was slain by Lady Kira? You, nincompoop! Eek! The rebel hunter is sure to be a vigilante who loves this kingdom. And it is that patriotism that led them to cloak their identity in the guise of Lady Kira. Such a patriot. Would never slay the High Priest! I guess it's only natural for Princess Rafa to see it that way, but I can't let it go at that. Besides, why would such a vigilante want to stop the purification rite in the first place? I haven't figured that one out yet. I rest my case! Still, if this rebel hunter had a compelling enough reason, they might have killed the High Priest after he ignored their warnings. You big dummy! You can't fool me! It was you who forged that warning letter! You are trying to shed your guilt onto our most sacred Lady Kira. Admit it! No, I never do such a thing! Now, your benevolence, let's try to remain rational about this. Grrr. Maya, did you show that letter to the police? No. Well, that was stupid, wasn't it? I was afraid that it would anger everybody needlessly, so I was waiting to show it to you, Nick. And judging by Benevolence's reaction, I'd say Maya was right to be worried. Wait, what There are a number of places on this letter where there are three holes in a row. Are these supposed to be some sort of message too? Not that we'll be finding out anytime soon, I suspect. Alright, accused, wrap it up. I guess they have more questions for me. Yeah, at least I have a better idea of what we're up against now. Nick, there's something I've been meaning to say. I don't need a lawyer this time. What are you talking about? It's just, you know that they have that Defense Culpability Act here in Karain, right? Well, if I'm found guilty, you'll be charged with abetting a criminal. Maya, thanks for thinking of me, but... Don't worry, Maya. We'll pull through this together somehow.
We always have, haven't we? Yeah, but we're not in Kansas anymore. True, but I've been through one trial here already, so I know what I'm getting myself into. We're gonna win this one, no matter what, because I believe in your innocence. Yeah, I know. We've always won because of your faith in me. That's right, so it's all aboard the Phoenix Freedom Express! Thank you, Nick. Well, I'll see you later. Doesn't that look brilliant, does it? Bravado will not save you tomorrow, and by then it will be too late to ask for mercy. We're going to beat this charge, you'll see. I don't care to understand every single word that was spoken. But I don't like the sound of that Phoenix Freedom Express one bit. Wait. Don't tell me you don't know what Freedom Express refers to. Ah! Of course I know! Do not presume to know what I do not know! I'm no closer to understanding why someone would want the High Priest dead. But given the use of the Warbard dagger and the existence of the warning letter, I'd say the rebel hunter disguised as Lady Kira is the real prime suspect. It's gonna be Maya. It might help if I knew a little more about this modern day Lady Kira. I wonder if anyone has any info on them. Maybe the first thing I should do is go someplace where locals like to gather. Can do, friend. Oh look, that's convenient. The bazaar has just appeared in my thing. I swear, Maya's gonna be... It's fucking... Come on. Like, he's gonna do the whole spiel. He's gonna spend 2 fucking hours proving that Lady Kira killed the bloke. And then Maya's gonna be like, by the way... Bit awkward. It's gonna happen. I can see it. Oh wow, do you want to take a picture of that ox dick again? I guess the bazaar is as good a place to start as any. Now, who should I... I see. So that is what a Freedom Express is. Consulting her pocket internet again, I see. Mr. Wright! That sounds like... You! Is Miss Meyer okay? I believe her, Mr. Wright. I know she didn't do it! Do you now, boy? Paul Conker! Your benevolence! You mustn't trust in lawyers, you. Are you not the accused from the last trial? Oh, what's wrong, Albie? Your benevolence speaks with the, you may speak in the vernacular, little monk. Now, what is your name? Yes, your benevolence. Albie Yorgade, your benevolence. Know this, Albie. Your soul is only as clean or filthy as the company you keep. I wish you'd stop insinuating that all lawyers are trash. But please forgive me, your benevolence, but Mr. Wright is a very trustworthy man. And I trust him as a lawyer. Oh my god! What's this? I'm sorry, forgive my insolence. If a common boy such as he can place his trust in lawyers, it can only be because of my failure at the Hall of Justice the other day. Ooh. Mr. Wright, your benevolence has sunk into the ground! She must really feel responsible for what happened in court that day. Let's give her some breathing room for now. I'm sure she'll be back on her feet in no time. In the meantime, do you mind if I ask you some questions? Of course not. I'm always glad to help. The Rebel Hunter. So what have you heard about the Rebel Hunter that was in the newspaper? Everyone's overjoyed at her appearance. They say she's the modern-day Lady Kira. So they're treating this Rebel Hunter like a mysterious protector of the people, huh? People have been on edge recently, what with that jailbreak and stuff. I sure hope they catch that escaped prisoner soon. Escaped prisoner? Yes, he was one of the vicious rebels that Lady Kira had captured. So there's a hardened criminal on the loose. That is bad news. Yes, but the modern-day Lady Kira is also super amazing. I mean, she takes down big, scary rebels all by herself. Yeah, that's not exactly something just anyone can do. Someone that strong could have easily overpowered and killed the High Priest. Hmm, and what about that escaped prisoner, Albie? So, what's the escaped prisoner supposed to be like? They say he's a vicious fiend who serves as Dirk's right-hand man. It's gonna be Beardy, isn't it? Dirk, as in the leader of that rebel group? Yes, the escapee serves that dreadful master of the Defiant Dragons. They say the prisoner is a former soldier and that he wields a big scary knife. Rumor has it he's a cold-blooded killer to boot. He sounds like a really dangerous man. He is, but the police still can't find him, even after exhaustive searching. Wait, I remember hearing about a prison.
Flashback!
Apex of this mountain! A prison?
Flash forward!
The prison is at the top of the Inner Sanctum's mountain, right? How did he even break out? No one really knows. He supposedly did it without any tools to speak of, too. Some say he must have fallen to his death. Personally, I'd like to believe he did. What a little shit! Otherwise, something like that terrible incident might happen again. Terrible incident? What was that about a terrible incident, Albie? It happened before I was even born, but... Queen Amara, the previous queen, was assassinated. And it was the rebel leader, Dirk, who did it. Oh, sorry. The previous queen was assassinated? That's kind of unsettling. Oh, it was the terrible deed of a heinous sinner. I mean, to take the life of such a gentle queen? Only someone with a dark, defiled soul could have done that. They really take their queen seriously here, like god-worshipping level serious. It really would take some pretty bold and blasphemous to assassinate one. Those Defiant Dragon Rebels are not afraid to do anything to accomplish their goals. That's why, with that escaped prisoner on the loose, who knows who might be killed next? So that's why the people of Kurayn are so afraid of that escape. And why they want the Rebel Hunter to take him out along with the other Rebels. So, is there anything else you could tell me about the Rebel Hunter, Lady Kira, Albie? I was just thinking there was something else, but what was it? Oh yeah! Here! What is it? Shardu found it. Why, that's the Warbard arrow! Feeling better now, Your Benevolence? This is no time to be feeling sorry for myself, for I am the Crown Princess of Kurayn. Now, let me see that, boy. Yes, Your Benevolence. It looks very much like one of the legendary weapons Lady Kira once used in battle. A three-pronged arrow? I could swear I've seen something resembling that arrowhead recently. Really? No flashback for that? Where did Shardu find it, Albie? Near Abba Inmi's house. Near the victim's house, huh? Something tells me I'd better look into this. Albie, can I ask you to take me to the High Priest's house? Yes, of course. Come to think of it, he was married with me. And his wife is the one who usually plays the part of Lady Kira in the purification rite. I should probably talk to her too. Away! Say, talking to his wife might be a little bit awkward though. Just a little bit. So this is where the High Priest lived. Wait a minute, this is where they brought me when my back gave out. And the woman in front of that altar, she must be the High Priest's wife. Hello, chum. Excuse me. Oh. Belieb. Yes, may I help you? I was hoping to speak with the High Priest's wife. Are you she? Please forgive the intrusion, Lady Belieb.
Oh, my. Your benevolence. Please, be at ease. What a terrible time this must be for you. I owe much to your husband. You have my deepest sympathies for your tragic loss. You honor me with your kind words. Look, dear, the royal priestess has come to visit us. You're fucking crazy. Yes, what's that? Oh, of course. Hee hee. She's talking with his funeral picture! Yeah, you're a bit fucking crazy! My husband, too, is delighted that the royal priestess is gracious with her presence. You can speak with Abba in me? No, I don't possess the power to speak with the dead, but I can feel his presence. What's that? No, that can wait till later, dear. She's definitely speaking with him. So, your benevolence, what is it that brings you to my humble abode? This lawyer is investigating your husband's death, and I am watching him to ensure it is not tampered with any of the evidence. I know this must be difficult, but could I ask you some questions? A good friend of mine has fallen under suspicion, you see. A friend of yours? So then, you must be Maya's friend from the States, correct? That's right. I'm sorry, but I'm still grieving. Isn't that right, dear? Yes, I know. Abba Inmi and his wife are one of the closest and most loving couples in Karain. If she is not ready to talk, I will not allow you to press her any further. She did just lose the love of her life. It would be incredibly insensitive of me to force answers out of her right now. But I need to talk to her if I want to learn more about the High Priest. Plus, there's the Warbard Arrow that Albie found near the house. There's too much I need to find out for me to leave just yet. Would it be okay if I stayed here for a little while? Barbhead! Have you not been listening to a word I said? Look, your benevolence, I'm sorry for our loss, but I'm running out of time. So what I will do is promise to leave if she doesn't change her mind. Please, let me talk to my husband about this. Yes, I know. No, don't. Not in front of the royal priestess. Now, if you would excuse me... Well, what the heck were they even talking about? You have but poured salt on her wounds. This is precisely why you lies are so despised. Arrgh! I was just trying to help Maya's case. I didn't mean to hurt Miss Inmi. Could it be that you actually possess a conscience? Of course I do! But I'm also desperate for information. So, what do you plan to do now? Pass the time by looking around the room, I guess, and see if she changes her mind. Just see that you do not touch anything you should not. Like a strange dildo collection. Guess I should watch what I touch then, just in case Princess Rafa gets mad at me. Wait, what the fuck is that? What is this scary-looking spiky thing? It is a floor cushion for heightening a practitioner's mental focus. Your ignorance astounds me. There is not a soul in Karain who would not recognize this. A floor cushion? You mean you're supposed to sit on this? How else would you suggest it be used? It looks like a torture device to me. What the fuck is that? Oh, it's a wanted poster for the rebel escapee everyone's talking about. What? Let me see that. That's horrible. Is that supposed to be that's horrible? Or am I reading too much into that? See, since I didn't get the fucking first one, I really want to know now. That's horrible. I think so. Senior member of insurgent leadership and former paratrooper of a foreign land, wanted for crimes against the kingdom, considered armed and dangerous. So he's ex-military, huh? His appearance alone exudes menace. He must be captured at once. Is something wrong? The bounty is 3 million dharmas, money that comes out of the people's tax payments. I shall have it lowered to about 1 million dharmas. You seem unexpectedly concerned with the people's welfare. Unexpectedly? How rude! Nina has always taught me that kingdoms that do not value its people come to ruin. As Crown Princess, it is only natural that I care for my people. How about sending some of that kindness this way? Well, I suppose I could. If you quit being a lawyer and paid taxes to our kingdom, that is. Oh, well. It was worth a shot. I bet we're gonna have to fucking defend her, aren't we? She's gonna get done for murder, then she's like, oh, bollocks, no, help me out. This looks like a wastebasket. Hey, there's an envelope sticking out. There are 3 holes in a row near the top. Now, where have I seen holes like this before? Scrounging around in other people's garbage like some stray dog. You are a pitiful creature indeed. What does it say here? Say what you will, but I've got a job to do. It says, to the High Priest. You cannot even read? You are even more pitiful than I had thought. So thanks, and I'll keep your words of wisdom in mind, your benevolence. Guess I should have studied some Quranese before I came. So the envelope was addressed to the High Priest, huh? But it's empty. Still, there's something about it. I'd better hang on to it. Alright, it's got 3 holes in it, and the other thing's got 3 holes in it, and you'd probably have to fold the other thing to get it into the envelope, so someone stamped 3 holes in the envelope, making a series of 3 holes in the bit of paper. Well done. This game looks like, kind of like checkers or chess. You mean to say you have never heard of... What? Cachou de Mal? I've heard people describe it as Quranese chess. So 2 players take turns moving their pieces in a bid to capture the other's king? Not quite. In Cachou de Mal, the object is the utter annihilation of your opponent. Furthermore, each piece is a special move that can only be used once per game. Special moves? It sounds like a game right up Myers' alley. There's a steel samurai patch on this bag. Guess the bag must be Myers. She probably left it here while she was performing that rite. Is this a piece of art of some sort? What a beautiful orb. Is something the matter? Barbed head, take 1 step back. Okay, done. Did you spot something? Yes, your dismal reflection. It was ruining the orb's beauty. Did you have to put it like that, your benevolence? What show is this? It is the Plumed Punisher, Warrior of Neo Twilight Realm. It is based on Lady Kira and is the #1 action hero show in Kurain. The Plumed Punisher, Warrior of Neo Twilight Realm. They really fucking love doing this shit, don't they? Yes, it is an entirely original show created right here in our kingdom. I'm not so sure about its originality, given its overall look and that theme song. Is something the matter? Well, it's just, we have an action hero show back home that is really similar to this. I'm guessing this show is why Myra is so into Lady Kira. There you go. Honestly, the theme song is exactly the same as the one for Myra's favourite show, The Steel Samurai, Warrior of Neo Oldie Tokyo. It's a popular action hero series filmed right in LA. Set in a city known as Neo Oldie Tokyo, it pits the Steel Samurai in Mortal Kombat against his nemesis, the Evil Magistrate. Myra's collected DVDs and merchandise from that series as long as I've known her. The Plumed Punisher seems awfully similar to the Steel Samurai. The Plumed Punisher originated here, in Kurain. Is that clear, Barbed Head? Yes, your benevolence. Note to self, never suggest that again. Yeah, ain't gonna worry about copyright and bullshit. You never know what's gonna happen. Oh, is that that prosecutor? Yeah. Isn't this that justice minister I met? But who's the woman in the picture next to him? She looks really important. Could she be the Queen of Kurain? Dunno, you didn't let us actually fucking see her! Alright, it's pretty much all this bollocks then. What a magnificent altar. Of course it is magnificent. It is for the Holy Mother, after all. The Holy Mother. Is she that faceless figure there? Such insolence! How do you not know who her holiness is on sight? Do you seek to cross over into the Twilight Realm right this instant? Sorry, it won't happen again! This is why lawyers are so despised, because they don't know things. Now listen well, depicting Her Holiness's face is the greatest taboo in all of Quranism. There are none alive today who know what her face really looks like, and that includes the members of the royal family. Wow, now there's an unusual custom. It's gotta be one heck of a secret if even the royal family can't know what she looks like. Any other bollocks lying around? Anything at all? Anything? I'm seeing a lack of- Oh, hang on, there we go. Ugh. A poster of the mountains? Oh, the Inner Sanctum Mountains featured against those other towering peaks. Those beautiful mountains are known as the Roof of Kurain. Oh, I see they've even included Mount Pony Pony in that poster. Mount Pony Pony? Is that the smaller peak to the left? Known as the Little Sanctum, it is just west of the Inner Sanctum. Is it not also beautiful? I suppose a lawyer with a defiled soul such as you could not perceive such beauty. No, that's not true. I think it's absolutely stunning. Mountain range poster. Oh, we're done. We're done. Lady Belieb has not had a change of heart, and simply waiting shall not change that. Can't we wait just a little longer? Wonder if she'll ever open up. Oh, you're still here. Lady Belieb. Miss Inmi, do you think you're ready to talk? Is it okay with you, dear? Yes, yes, I will let him know. Lady Belieb, you don't have to speak to this lawyer if it is not your wish. No, it's quite alright. If my husband was still with us, he would say... As much as it pains me to have my lovely wife speak on such matters, if it would help to find the truth, then ask whatever you may. Okay, I'll take you up on your generous offer. Wait, did Mrs. Inmi call herself lovely just now? Well, whatever are you waiting for? Ask your questions quickly so your departure may be just as swift. Yes, of course. Alright, what do you got, woman? Do you have any idea why your husband might have been killed? Was he acting differently or doing anything out of the ordinary lately? No, I don't recall anything of the sort. Ah, this is really difficult. Did anybody have a grudge against him? He was a kind man and one of peace. He would never do anything that would cause someone to bear a grudge against him. Oh, shit! Wait, what? How the fuck can he do that? He hasn't got a bag of tar and what's him and thunk it on. These are Cyclocks! Ah, have we seen these yet? I don't know if we've seen these yet. No, I don't think we have. This is another gimmick. This means Mrs. Inmi is trying to hide something from me. This is the Megatar Maya gave to me all those years ago. And it has a really amazing power for some fucking reason. It reacts when someone is hiding something. And allows me to see the Cyclocks that are holding that person's mind shut. Whenever I see any, I only have to touch my Magatama to try and unlock them. Unlocking them all usually allows me to coax the truth out of someone. Let's fucking do it. The High Priest. Cyclocks. They appeared when I asked her whether anyone held a grudge against her husband. That must mean that Mrs. Inmi thought of someone who just might have such a grudge. Let's just stir the pot a little and see what happens. Mrs. Inmi, I have an idea who your husband's real killer might be. That would be Maya, would it not? No, of course not. It has to be someone with a motive to kill him. This is who I believe had a reason to kill... What? I don't fucking know! I guess Lady fucking Kira! It was the Rebel Hunter disguised as Lady Kira. Everyone's talking about her. Ah! I know not of what you speak. Really? Because she even made the front page recently. Quack, 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 quack. I am but a humble servant of Lady Kira. What reason would she have to kill someone as insignificant as I? Actually, I have something that just might show why Lady Kira would kill Abbot Bollocks. This is a letter of warning from Lady Kira. Maya found it. It was in the Inner Sanctum, and only Maya and your husband were there at the time. Arr! This letter reached its intended recipient, your husband, the High Priest, didn't it? How do you know Maya wasn't lying to you? Because I've never seen that letter before, and I doubt my husband ever did either. Sorry, but I have evidence that proves this warning was meant for your husband. Well, that's fucking convenient, isn't it? What's that? It's an envelope, addressed to the High Priest. The warning letter was delivered to your husband inside this, wasn't it? Arrgh! What nonsense is this? How can you prove the warning was delivered in this envelope? There's gotta be some way to prove it. Wait a second, don't the envelope and the warning letter have something in common? I think there just might be something that leaks the envelope to the warning letter. There is! Yeah, so that proof is right here on the warning letter. Oh, this is gonna be really finicky, isn't it? I could fucking tell. Oh no, is it alright? Oh no, it's alright. Okay, fair enough, fair enough. The three holes in the envelope are in the same shape and arrangement as the holes in the warning letter. And if you fold the letter in thirds and place it in the envelope, the holes line up. Arrgh! As for what made the holes, I believe it was... What? I don't fucking know. Oh, yeah, I do. That makes sense. They were made by this Warbard arrow, one of the weapons favored by Lady Kira. The warning was folded in thirds, placed in the envelope addressed to the High Priest, and delivered to your husband on the points of this arrow. That makes sense. Hey, ah, bollocks. Yeah, Tina, you crazy bitch.
Unlock successful.
Woo. Yay. Are you ready to tell me the truth now? No. I admit the warning was sent to my husband, but he was not an insurgent. Then why did you keep it a secret? Because the authorities might have suspected him of being one if I hadn't. I guess that makes sense. If the Rebel Hunter was after him, I can see how people might at least suspect. We are a Quranist kingdom, as such rising up against the monarchy is the same as blaspheming Quranism itself. Your husband was a devout priest of Quranism, and you feared that his good name would be tarnished if the warning went public. Yes. That makes sense, but is it the honest truth? What if the High Priest really was a rebel? The Rebel Hunter would have had a motive to kill him. Still... This just doesn't feel like the right time to ask her about it. Could you tell me a little more about the warning? It arrived about 3 days before the purification rite. When we woke that morning, it was already there by the side of our bed. It was by the side of your bed? Yes, we had the whole house locked up tight. And yet, someone still managed to slip in. Oh, it was so frightening, wasn't it, dear? But you didn't contact the police. Because you didn't want them to suspect your husband of being a rebel. That's right. If only we had told the police, maybe Taurus would still be alive today. Oh, lovely wife. No need to fret, my dear. Aww. My only regret is that I left you all alone. Bobhead! That is quite enough. Yes, you're probably right. Mrs. Inmay, I'm sorry to have bothered you at such a difficult time. Don't be silly. I'm happy if I've helped. Your benevolence may swiftly shine light upon the truth. Barbed Head, you seem bent on casting suspicion upon Lady Kira. And by doing so, you seek to deflect the blame from the real killer, Maya Fey. That is the only logical conclusion. I'm in no position to disprove her at this point. If only I could find something to support my theory that the High Priest was a rebel. The only other person who might know more about Abbot Inmay would be Maya. They might be done questioning her by now. Maybe I'll stop by the detention center. There! My mother has said what? It seems I must go. Did something happen? Yes, my mother has decreed that a rite shall be held for the High Priest's passing, and that she shall conduct the prayer of lament therein. Her Eminence has so decreed, has she? Oh, but she should not concern herself with a humble priest like my husband. No, it is only natural, considering his meritorious service. The rite will be held at the palace. You are to accompany me there at once, Lady Belieb. Thank you, Your Benevolence. My husband is most delighted too. How wonderful for you, Miss Inmay. A direct decree from the Queen. That must be quite an honour. Barbed Head, you are coming as well. Huh? But I don't have much time left to investigate. As the one charged with monitoring you, you must remain within my sight at all times. Besides, it will take but a moment. Now come along! Ugh, arguing the point will probably just make things worse for me. I'd better let her have her way this time. Or maybe we'll have to try and fucking like defend the Queen or some shit, and her daughter will have to fucking do the doobry, like, against her, and then she'll be like, ah! All possibilities! Oh!
The fuck is that?
Welcome, Lady Belieb. Crikey. So this is the Queen of Karain. What is wrong with you, Barbed Head? Show some respect! Huh? Should I bow? Or prostrate myself? No, it is quite alright. Stay as you are. Mother. Your Eminence, I would like to give thanks to you. You honour both me and my husband. His exemplary service deserves to be honoured. Oh, but what a terribly trying time this must be for you, Lady Belieb. May my prayer comfort your soul, and that of your dearly departed husband. Nothing would please me more. Oh, Your Eminence, your words are wasted on my humble husband and I. Sniffle! Now that's what I call a commanding presence. So, you are the lawyer of whom my daughter speaks. Yes, Your Eminence! I am so very honoured to make your acquaintance. Acquaintanceship? Alright, don't fucking blow smoke up her ass, Jesus. I'm humbled to bask in your resplendence? Ah. Did I ever do it? I have no idea how to talk to a queen. Ho-ho, may the Holy Mother's blessing be upon you. Now then, Lady Palib, let us go to the Chamber of Prayer. Rafer, you are to accompany us too. Yes, Mother. Wow, the Queen is seriously something else. Heh. The Prayer of Lament, huh? Don't see how that'll do any good. It's Justice Minister Inga! Hmm? Who are you, buddy? Nice to see you again, Minister Inga. Again? Have we met? I'm Phoenix Wright. We met in the accused lobby the other day. Alright, blue suit, jagged hair. You're that liar who brought my daughter down a peg or two. Your daughter? Yeah, Rafa. He's Princess Rafa's father? So he's Queen Garan's husband? You planning on sticking your fat nose in this mess too? The accuser's a good friend of mine. Like I said the last time, you better watch yourself, see? Do you mind if I ask you a few questions? You want to question me? That would be great. You got balls for a lawyer. Guess I could play along a bit. But I got things to do, see? So we'll have to talk while I work. What are you working on? You're just standing there with an unlit cigar in your mouth, you fucking weirdo. I wanted to let you know that I'll be the defense lawyer on this case too. Well, don't say I didn't warn you. You only won last time because that idiotic prosecutor filed false charges. But it's gonna be different this time. I got Karain's top prosecutor on this one, see? I don't care who I go up against. I'm going to prove my client innocent. You haven't forgotten that little thing called the Defense Culpability Act, have you? The thing that kills you? You fucking remember that? It was only mentioned 18 billion times! Blow this one and you'll suffer the same fate as the accused. How could I forget? Don't flashback, oh thank god. Heh, you lawyers are all the same. You strut your stuff till the DC Act comes down hard. Then you start begging and pleading for your lives. It's really hard to watch, I tell you. Well, I don't plan on letting it come to that. Were you the one who wrote the Defense Culpability Act? Heh, maybe I did, maybe I didn't. What's it to you? Either way, as Justice Minister, I'm going to enforce the thing. It started as a way to counter the dirty tricks of your trade, like falsified evidence. But it turned out to be quite handy. Efficient, even. Handy? Efficient? Yeah, made my job real easy. Any goons who crossed me or the Goron administration, they're gonna get just what they deserve. Especially those rebel scum. You can get away with that here? Better watch your mouth, lawyer. I enforce the law in Karain. I'm above the law! And being that I'm the Queen's husband, that makes me king. Well, yeah. Sounds about right. No, I'm pretty sure the Queen is the boss around here. Go on, say what you're thinking so I can charge you with lesser majesty. I don't know what the fuck that is. Look, I can't get myself arrested now. Listen up, lawyer. We got a low crime rate and a populace that lives in peace. And that's all thanks to the DC Act. So I don't want to hear any more lip about it. How exactly is that? Also, it's like, you're going to introduce a law that means that lawyers will stop... If their client gets proven guilty, then they'll receive the same punishment. How exactly does that stop falsifying evidence? Surely that would make every single lawyer falsify evidence well, it means their lives, really? Because it is! Because if they lose, then they die. So, yeah, I would have thought that would increase evidence falsifying. But hey, you know, whatever, plot devices, right? That are hammered on about every 5 fucking seconds. But I can't defend my client unless I can speak my mind. Heh, even without the DC Act, Dirk and his insurgent scum buddies' days are numbered. What's that supposed to mean? Let's just say I got a little trick up my sleeve, so I'd watch it if I were you. Because you got a defiant attitude, like one of them dragon dupes. Say, White, you know what these are? No, what? Orders of execution. They really pile up if I start slacking off. What? And tomorrow I'll have even more work to do, processing the one for your little friend. And if you really do defend her, I'll have to add one more to the pile for you. But you're not stupid enough to waste your life on that criminal, are you? Wow. What a sleazy dickbag. I'm sure we'll face him in the final trial. Don't worry, I'll make sure to lighten your workload, Inga. I won't give you a single execution order to sign tomorrow. I have returned, Barbhead! Your benevolence. Are you done with the rite? Yes. It was performed flawlessly. Lady Belive stayed behind to speak with Mother. I hope this will help ease her sorrow, even if just a little. So, you have been speaking with my father? Yes, you could say that. My father is a great man. He works tirelessly to keep the peace in our kingdom. Karai, as it stands today, owes everything to the efforts of my mother and my father. You should feel deeply honored. He's a bit of a scumbag. Under normal circumstances, they would have never spoken so readily with a lawyer. Yes, of course. It seems Rafer doesn't know what her father is really like. Well, now that we're done here, let's go see if I can talk to Maya now. Oh, we're just zipping over there. Yeah, we are. Well, I'm assuming this will be before the trial, then. Oh, it's you, Nick. Maya, are you okay? The questioning wasn't too harsh, was it? No, I'm alright. How about you? Make any progress? Well, I haven't found any conclusive evidence that could prove your innocence, but I have a small lead. Really? But for right now, I'd like to ask you about the High Priest. Sure, ask away. By the way, what's the princess doing with you still, Nick? Doesn't she have anything better to do? Doesn't seem like it. I heard that! How rude! Of course I have many other things I could be doing. It's just a thought, but do you think the High Priest could have been a rebel? A rebel? Why would he even think that? Because if he was, then the rebel hunter Lady Kira would have had a motive to kill him. What? Uh-oh, Princess Rafer overheard me. What idiocy is this? Abba in me, a rebel? It is beyond the pale. My mother has offered the prayer of lament to his soul. That is the sort of person he was. All right. I was just raising the possibility. I would not listen to such tomfoolery. That's a great word. That's a corker. She stormed out. Oh, well, nothing we can do about it. Do you recall the High Priest doing anything suspicious? Come to think of it, he seemed unusually restless during the rite. He kept glancing up at the sky, though I have no idea why. He was restless and kept looking up at the sky? That doesn't really tell us much, does it? Anything else come to mind? Sorry, that's about it. Guess this is all I'm gonna learn about the High Priest right now. Oh, but there is one thing I should follow up on. Really?!
Oh, stop flashing back, please! Even if it's like 5-second flashbacks, it just pisses me. It's like they have zero faith in their audience. Like, fucking hell, man. Come on.
Right, what are we doing? Maya, about what you said earlier, why can't you tell anyone you're able to channel spirits? Oh, that! You know how all the queens are also spirit mediums here? I heard. It was kind of a shock at first, though. In Karanaism, spirit channeling is a secret art that can only be performed by the queen. Really? There's like fucking 4 people we've seen who can do it. No one else is supposed to be able to do it. I see. So spirit... Yeah, fucking like your entire clan in old games could fucking do it. I see. So spirit channeling is a symbol of power or authority, then, in that sense. I can see why it would look bad if a nobody from another country were able to do it, too. Spirit channeling is the Karain tradition. It was developed from a Karanist style that was brought to the US via Japan. But it seems like my clan's spiritual power is greater than that of the average Karanese. It may be a quirk due to how our styles diverge, but I don't really know. So if spirit channeling is a power possessed only by the queens of Karain, and it's a power that somehow made its way down the line to Maya, then I guess that makes Queen Garan and Princess Rafer distant relatives of Maya's? Anyway, it's not like there's some kind of rule about it. It's just, I'd rather not have it become an issue or anything. That's why mediums who come here to train hide the fact that they can channel spirits. I see. I had no idea it was so complicated. Isn't it just? Either way, training here is a must to fulfill the qualification needed to become the master. And what is this qualification to become the master? To be able to channel spirits of one's own volition and without fail every time. Like, remember how my spirit channeling was always hit or miss? I only ever succeeded about 30% of the time. Yeah, and it was more like spirits possessed her as opposed to her channeling them. So you can do it every single time now, whenever you want? Yeah! At least, I think. You think? Well, I haven't actually tried channeling anyone since I completed my training here. But once I get back home, I plan on taking the final spirit medium test. I'll have to try channeling one spirit after another in a marathon channeling session! Only those who pass the test are worthy of becoming the master, huh? Yeah, but I know I can do it. I'm gonna ace that test and become the next master. After all, I can't let my clan and the other villagers down. Right. Mai's the next big hope of Karain Village. That's gotta be a lot of pressure. So speaking of similarities, I've noticed another similarity between our countries besides spirit channeling. I saw a show on TV earlier that reminded me of the Steel Samurai. Oh, you must mean the Plume Punisher, Warrior of Neo Twilight, bollocks. So you've already seen it, yes. You really don't miss a beat. Actually, it was her benevolence who told me all about it. There is not a single person in Karain who does not know of it. Oh, your benevolence, you're back. As the Royal Priestess, I am charged with monitoring your movements. So, I have changed my mind. For in order to fulfill my duty, I must not avert my ears, not even from your blasphemous theories. Her sense of duty is commendable. But I wouldn't mind if she backed off a bit. Great timing, your benevolence. There's actually something I wanted to show off to the both of you, actually. Show off? Maya sure seems excited all of a sudden. Yep. Ta-da! What was that? It's an ultra-rare Bloom Punisher strap! There's only one of them in the whole world! It was specially made to promote the TV show! Yeah, you're the owner of this strap?! Don't tell me, you're a Bloom Punisher fan too, your benevolence. No, of course not! Only little children watch that show! I have no interest in such things! Right. No, I am telling the truth! Sure, let's just leave it at that. So how did you get your hands on that, Maya? Hehehe! I found a kindred spirit in a Plume Punisher fan here in Karain. It resulted in an exchange of cultures transcending national borders. And by the cultural exchange, you mean you swapped TV show promo merchandise? You bet! I traded my Steel Samurai watch for this strap. It's a super rare watch that plays the Steel Samurai theme song when the alarm goes off. My newfound Karani's friends were so happy, I got this one-of-a-kind strap in return. I guess there are people like that wherever you go, even here in Karain. Watch this! When you press the Magatama on a belt, it plays the show's theme song! That sounds just like the Steel Samurai theme song. What are you talking about? Can't you hear the folk instruments in the intro and the exotic tones throughout? Plus, the Steel Samurai has Japanese taiko drums that go... Yes, that. Thank you. Right. Right. Guess my ears just aren't as good as yours. Anyway, I have this amazing idea for a new show. The Plume Punisher versus the Steel Samurai. I'm gonna totally go pitch it to some TV stations when I get back home. It's gonna be a huge hit. Right, your benevolence? I have no interest in such things. Well, if nothing else, talking about the Plume Punisher is thankfully seemed to cheer Maya up a bit. It's getting late. Try to get some sleep, okay, Maya? And leave tomorrow to me. Okay, thanks, Nick. I think I've covered just about everything. Time to head back to the temple and go over everything I've learned so far. Oh man! Oh, fuck, an hour and 10 minutes. Eh, whatever. We'll finish the Because I'm assuming this is going to be it. And we'll learn some sort of weird, spooky thing, and we'll, yeah. I'll tell you what, again, this, like, I swear the fucking investigation part for the last thing was like 4 fucking hours, so, you know, the fact that this is maybe 2.5 is a bit more modest, to be fair. It's getting late. Won't be long until sundown. Mr. Wright, you're benevolent! Fuck off, kid! Are you done with your investigation for today? Pretty much. I thought I'd go over what I've learned so far. Care to join me? Yes, please allow me to help. Okay, first, we know that the High Priest received a warning 3 days ago. It was from someone claiming to be Lady Kira, and it told him not to perform the rite. That's right, it was that rebel hunter. But what of it? That's what I'm not sure of yet. Why would Lady Kira want to stop the rite? If you could solve that mystery... Right, I could figure out her motive for threatening the High Priest. It might be the break I need, but I just don't know enough right now to act on that lead. How unfortunate for you, Barbed Head. Your only hope is pure speculation. That shall not stand up in the Hall of Justice. He's fucking made it stick more times than you can count, lady! Seriously, the bullshit that comes out of this man's mouth. You have no actual proof of Lady Kira's involvement in this crime, after all. Yeah, the warning letter alone can't prove who killed the High Priest. I'll give you one last chance to withdraw before you are charged under the DC Act. Your benevolence! While it is true you did not forge or suppress any evidence, that is perhaps a product of my careful monitoring of your every move. I wasn't planning to do anything like that in the first place, your benevolence. But I am going to prove Maya's innocence, within the confines of the law. How can you be so sure you will? Because of my undying faith in my clients, that is a lawyer's greatest weapon. What nonsense. You have chosen to dig your own grave. When next we meet, it shall be in the Hall of Justice. As Royal Priestess, it is my duty to reveal the truth through the divination seance. This time, I will prove that the insights I glean thereof are the very truth itself. Prepare yourself, for this shall be your last trial, and your last rites. Rah! Tomorrow shall end with you under the headsman's axe. She's a lovely soul. Tomorrow, I'll be defending Mara in that so-called Hall of Justice again. Flashback. Maybe? Oh, there you go. Wasn't sure about that one. Took a while to flashback the flashback. That whole seance thing makes Charles here completely different from those back home. Plus, I don't have a shred of conclusive evidence. On the other hand, I've got plenty of confusion and anxiety to spare. I'll have to think of something. After all, I'm the only lawyer in all of Karine. I have to do this. I will do this! I'll prove my innocence is the last thing I do! Ah! To be continued. Oh, fucking... Right, well, I believe that will be it for today. Jolly good fun. I quite like that, like I say, because it's just a completely made up bullshit place on the spot, there is actually quite a nice bit of sort of, you know, flavour text and, you know, sort of world building for it, which I appreciate. Although, again, that's kind of one of the good things about it, because the world building, as well as, you know, world building, also gives you evidence and provides things for you to think about in regards to actually solving the crazy fucking puzzle they present to you. So, I want to say it's kind of organic in the way it does things. It's just the organicness surrounds this ball of completely insane gibberish. So, yeah. But again, just as long as we don't get the whole fucking, "Oh, don't solve it right now, I'm gonna kill you on the spot, because the DC Act, 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 DCA, 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 will kill you, it will kill you, I'm gonna kill you, we're all gonna kill you, you must kill yourself, lawyer."
If that happens again, I'm gonna have a fucking problem, because it's like, it's not, okay? It's not. It's very, very, very fucking boring and fucking tedious. It's just, ugh. It doesn't serve to do anything, it just serves to fucking piss me off. Just trying to add extra layers of, oh no, intrigue, oh no, he must win. But it's like, again, you've somehow managed to, I think... Alright, yeah, the first one, you didn't care about, you might care about Albie a bit. Is it Albie? I think it was Albie, I can't quite remember anymore. Even though he's right fucking there. You know, you might care about him a bit, but it's like, when you've got Trucy, who, if you've played the games before, I mean, seriously, who would consider this a jumping on point, but whatever. Trucy, who you should care about if you like the games before, and Maya, who you should care about if you like the games before. Stop trying to fucking add, oh, but if you don't save Maya, you'll die. And it's like, well, fuck, okay, that doesn't really change anything. You're just wasting my time by trying to add extra, you know, incentive, when the incentive is right fucking there, you pillux. Ah, I hate it, I really do. It's the one thing that's dragging down an otherwise perfectly enjoyable game. Anyway, I've enjoyed, and I'll see you, I suppose, tomorrow when I wake up and we do more of this shit. Anyway, see you in a bit. Peace.